A big move for 2020. Democratic Senator Kamala Harris of California just announced her candidacy for president. CNN's Kyung Lah joins us now live in Washington with the very latest. Kyung.
She just made that announcement on Good Morning America, John, and we are anticipating shortly that she'll be posting a video to her social media accounts. It will officially announce that she is indeed going to be running for president. And in that video, she'll be calling on her supporters, saying that now is the time to fight.
That's why I'm running for president of the United States.
Senator Kamala Harris announcing her presidential campaign's core principles on Martin Luther King Day.
Truth, justice, decency, equality, freedom, democracy. These aren't just words. They're the values we as Americans cherish. And they're all on the line now.
I intend to fight for truth and transparency and trust. I intend to fight.
California's junior senator is notable both in biography.
I hope you got it.
I do.
And her two-year tenure in the Senate. Supporters hail Harris's rapid-fire questioning in the Senate from Supreme Court nominees.
Can you think of any laws that give the government the power to make decisions about the male body?
I'm not thinking of any right now, Senator.
To Justice Department officials.
Yes
or no, sir?
He has the full independence that is authorized by those regulations.
Are Senator, you willing as I said, to do as has been done before?
Would the senator suspend?
Making more than one of them squirm.
I'm not able to be rushed this fast. It makes me nervous.
A lot of the work I've done has been inspired.
The native of Oakland says she embodies everything California stands for and what the president is against. She is the daughter of immigrants, a father from Jamaica and a mother from southern India, both active in the civil rights era.
So it was about fighting for justice. It was about fighting to make sure that all people had a say in their future.
Harris graduated from Howard University, returning to Oakland to become a prosecutor. As a San Francisco district attorney, Harris crafted innovative programs to reform the criminal justice system at a time when other prosecutors were taking a tough-on-crime approach. And despite political pressure from her own party, she refused to seek the death penalty against the killer of a police officer, sticking to a core campaign pledge and personal belief.
Humbled to be chosen to be the next Attorney General of the state of California.
But she would defend the death penalty as California's first Black woman Attorney General, still personally opposed, but upholding state law, coming under fire from activists.
I now declare you spouses for life.
When the Supreme Court allowed marriage equality to stand in California, she officiated the first legal same-sex marriages in 2013.
Any day that justice is delayed, I would suggest justice is denied.
All part of her pledge to be a progressive prosecutor.
It is a false choice to suggest that one is either in favor of the Second Amendment or in favor of reasonable gun safety rules. We can be both.
That history is both an asset and an opening for attack.
We are so brave and we are so.
A question that may follow her to the campaign as it did on her book tour. Is it possible to be both a top cop and a reformer for progressives?
What do you say to those who hear that and read that and still say, like, you're anti-police?
Well, it's just not true.
I mean, I had to ask.
That's why I say we got to talk truth. It's just not true. It's not true. It's not true, period.
Now, this week, Senator Harris heads to campaign in South Carolina, and then this Sunday, she returns to Oakland. It is her birthplace, and it is there that she will kick off officially her presidential campaign. She unveiled her core staff today, and she also revealed her campaign slogan, John. It will be Kamala Harris for the people. These are the words that she spoke in the courtroom as a prosecutor. John.
All right, Kyung Lah for us in Washington. Thank you so much. This was the announcement just moments ago. Let's watch.
The president of the United States.
Yay. Well, and,
and I'm very excited about it.
You
heard her say president of the United States. I'm assuming the words she spoke before that were, I am running to be president of the United States. Joining us now is CNN national politics reporter Maeve Reston, who covers Kamala Harris out in California and knows so much about her and this decision. One housekeeping note here. I noticed she announced she's running for president, not an exploratory committee. I take that to mean she wants to prove how serious she is?
Yeah, her staff decided that she was ready, John, to just jump right in. They didn't want to go the route of the exploratory committee the way that Kirsten Gillibrand and Elizabeth Warren has. She's been gearing up for this for a long time, and she was just ready to go.
Two other things I noticed. Number one, the timing of the announcement today is Martin Luther King Jr. Day. Kamala Harris, an African-American woman running to be president. What symbolism are they trying to hit there?
Well, obviously, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. has been a huge hero of Kamala Harris's for a long time, and she talks about never resting in terms of his path, trying to reach a path toward justice. But also today, it is, I think, 47 years to the week when Shirley Chisholm announced her announcement that she was going to run as the first Black woman to run for president. So another one of Kamala Harris's heroes there, and she actually has incorporated Chisholm's colors from her campaign back in the 70s into her own logo, Kamala Harris for the People.
Shirley Chisholm race, a groundbreaking race 40 years later now, touching back on that history. I also took note, Kyung Lah told us the slogan, For the People. Kamala Harris, I think intentionally, it seems to me at least, trying to focus on her legal background here.
Yeah, absolutely. And of course, her legal background as a prosecutor, then later as DA of San Francisco, and then Attorney General of California, a huge asset for her in this campaign. It is not something that you would expect from an African-American woman to pursue a career as a prosecutor, but also kind of a double-edged sword for her. Parts of her record, because it is so long and complex, have come under fire from criminal justice advocates, even though she has been working on reforms like recidivism since, you know, back in 2003 and 2004, when not as many people are talking about it. And it's also key to her path going forward. She is going to try to do decently well in Iowa and New Hampshire, but really make a strong launch in South Carolina. And then, John, when you look at the calendar beyond that, you have all of those states in the Southeast where the African-American vote dominates the Democratic primary electorate, Alabama, Louisiana, all of those states. And she hopes to be able to consolidate that African-American vote, start racking up those delegate wins, and get enough momentum to push through to the nomination.
Mark your calendar. What, today is January 21st, and we just had a discussion about delegates in the Democratic primary. Maeve, I have to let you go, but just biggest of big pictures here. This is really, in some ways, the most major announcement we have seen to date. This shakes up the Democratic race at a very early stage. We knew it was coming, but now that it's there, it's a big deal.
It is a big deal. You know, obviously, Kamala Harris has had a series of firsts throughout her career, but she is leaning heavily into this historic moment. She sees the opportunity to galvanize African-American voters and really voters of all races. We saw that in her visits in Iowa last year. And she did foster also this strong connection with women in the Brett Kavanaugh hearings last year.
All right, Maeve Reston, thanks so much for being with us this morning. Appreciate it.
Thank you.